Dynamics 365 is a full suite of business applications, everything from dealing with your customers right through to dealing with your back office functions, all covered here, and I'm going to take you through it in under 10 minutes. As a starting point here, they are modular applications that work together. They can be configured or customized to meet your needs. And importantly, this is all part of the broader Microsoft stack. So if you're using things like Teams, Outlook, Word templates, Excel, and so on, you'll find all of those things built in and ready to go because the Microsoft stuff works well with the Microsoft stuff. Everything you see here can also be integrated with other applications that you already use as well. So you can take one of these and work with other things you've already got, or some of them, or all of them, as you like. When we talk about business applications, they generally fall into two main categories, and Dynamics 365 covers both of these things. The first one is CRM, Customer Relationship Management. This is about all of those sort of front-facing type things that interact with your customers, customer service, selling, marketing, those types of things. The other one is ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning, which is more of your back office functions, managing your finances, inventory, supply chain, and so on. So let's have a look at each of these in turn and the apps in the Dynamics stack that are available. First up on the CRM side, and within the Dynamics stack, these applications are often grouped together and called customer engagement. We have applications for sales, service, and marketing. First up, we have Dynamics 365 Sales. This is the CRM piece, and in fact, it used to be called Dynamics 365 CRM as well, so you'll find that label still out there. This is essentially the piece you use to manage your customer relationships, the organizations you work with, the people who work for those organizations, your whole pipeline from getting new leads into your organization through an opportunity process to closing new business, and all of the activities associated with that. Next up, we have customer service. At the core of customer service is a case management capability. Something comes in, a ticket, a service request, something like that, and you're managing it end to end through that process. That includes having things put in queues. They can be automatically routed to the right agent, escalated service level agreements, and so on. You've also got a knowledge base in there and scripts and things that you can use for your agents. This can also handle omni-channel customer service. So any channel that your customers want to work with you in, that's email, phone, chat, WhatsApp, SMS, social media, any of those things, including self-service capabilities via chatbots and a portal, all of that is part of the customer service app. Best friends with customer service is field service. So if you have a scenario where you need to dispatch skilled workers, skilled technicians out into the field to provide service, then that's what this one is for. So this is using work order management. It can also handle proactive service with IoT devices. There's a mobile capability with this one as well. And this connects seamlessly so that you can actually go from customer service through to field service if your scenario requires that concept of a service ticket that sometimes results in a work order and dispatching someone out into the field. There's also some really cool scheduling capability across both of these apps if you want to schedule agents by skill, by geography, by availability, by caseload, all those kinds of things. You can use that across both of those service applications. We also have a really sophisticated marketing capability that is natively connected to everything we've just talked about. No exporting or importing data, it's part of the same platform. So those contacts that you've got in your sales and service applications are the same contact, the same database that's in your marketing application. This is marketing automation. You can segment based on all of that data in your sales and service applications, or you can set off real-time triggers, like somebody visits a website or somebody visits a physical location, as a way of communicating in real time. This goes across email, SMS, push notifications, and other channels that can come in there as well. It also handles subscription, preference, and consent management. You can set up forms for people to register for events. You manage your end-to-end event process in there as well as marketing landing pages. The concept here is complete customer journey orchestration. So this is not standalone marketing automation. This is fully connected to everything else, which means you can actually start with a marketing journey where perhaps you're sending out an email, but then maybe somebody, you know, makes a purchase over a certain amount and you want to notify a key account manager to follow up on that, then you can create a task or hand that off seamlessly back into the sales application or into the service application. You might, for instance, have have as part of your journey to automatically exit someone from the journey if there is a customer service ticket or a case in there, so that you're not sending the wrong information at the wrong time. So completely seamlessly connected marketing automation system with those sales and service areas. Also within this customer engagement type of concept, we have a customer data platform called Customer Insights, designed to unify your data. So if you've got customer data sitting across a whole lot of different siloed systems, and you want that golden 360 degree view record of a customer, single view of your customer, individuals or accounts, it can handle either, it does that. But it also goes a lot further. It allows you to do very sophisticated segmenting across all of those things, including smart segmenting, lookalike segmenting, AI-based predictions out of the box, or bring your own machine learning models. And then you take all of that and you activate it or export it. You can send it out to social media, Facebook advertising, or to search engine providers, or to your marketing application, if that's not Dynamics. If it is Dynamics, then it's all seamlessly connected up there as well. And finally, customer voice. There is a built-in survey tool. This is a great little capability for customer satisfaction surveys. It'll do sentiment analysis, NPS scoring, you know, scoring out of 5, like it scores, all sorts of things. And it can be triggered from anything that happens in those sales and marketing applications as well. So when a customer service case is closed, for instance, in the service app, I want to send a satisfaction survey. And then when that comes back in, that's connected back up to that same customer record. On the ERP side, finance and operations here, we have a range of applications that help you manage the back office side of your business: finance, supply chain, commerce, e-commerce, human resources, and project operations. I'm going to really focus on those first two here. The finance system is a full enterprise capable way of managing the finances for your organization. You'll find this covers everything you need end to end for finance: general ledger, accounts payable, accounts receivable, cost accounting, and project accounting. We've also got within the platform here supply chain management capabilities. So if you need to manage your inventory, production and distribution planning, and demand forecasting, all of that is there as well. The other applications in this side of things, there's an e-commerce platform fully connected back into that finance system. We've got a human resources system for managing your employees and your staff, and also project operations for project management back into all of this as well. Also on the ERP side, if you're in small business, there's a fully contained app in here called Business Central. So this is actually providing you with a finance and operations capability for small to mid-sized business, as well as some sales and service. So if you're in that sort of size of business, this is an app that's well worth looking at, because it's got the whole thing covered in one go. But wait, there's more. There are also some other apps in here. So we've got some amazing mixed reality capability. There is Remote Assist, which allows, if you've got a technician out in the field, they can be using a HoloLens and you can be guiding them through what they're doing. So perhaps you've got a newer technician or someone who's not skilled in a specific task. Someone back in a head office can be looking at what they're doing and guiding them through it as if they were there in person. Guides provides workers with a step-by-step hologram graphic instruction type of screen, and Connected Spaces in the retail area allows you to get visualization and real-time action on movement within those spaces or within those stores. We've also got intelligent order management on the supply chain side, which can connect up, if you've got an existing supply chain and e-commerce system, that can connect up to those things and allow you to bring AI to optimize those processes. And last but certainly not least, fraud protection, which uses AI to protect you against all sorts of payment and refund and online fraud for your system. The other important thing to understand about Dynamics 365 is that it's part of this broader Microsoft stack. It's sitting sideways with all of the Microsoft 365 or Office 365 applications. So all of that communication activity is part of the same platform. It's also sitting on top of tools that allow you to configure and customize GitHub for pro developers and Microsoft Power Platform for low-code extensibility across automation, custom applications, chatbots, reporting, and portals. All of this sits on Microsoft Azure, so that Azure Active Directory login, when you log into any Microsoft product, you're logging into all of the same things, and all of that identity management and security management is part of that platform. If you'd like to understand more about Power Platform, check out my video here which goes through it, or my other video here which is a demo of Dynamics 365 Sales. Thanks for watching.